Hi once again. This week we're going to be looking at Colossal by Wolfmother. First thing we have to do with the riff for Colossal is tune down to drop D. So as I've mentioned before, the quickest way to do this, you can play an open D string and then the E string and tune it down. So you have that nice low D power chord too. So the first bar of the riff, what we're doing is we start off with an open D power chord on these, kind of playing the bottom three strings here. That lasts for a beat. Then after that, what we're doing is we're hammering from the 10th to the 12th fret in the A string. And we finish that off with 10th fret in the D string. So you have this. A little bit of vibrato in that as well. Then what we do is we play the open D power chord for 2/8 notes. So that first bar sounds like this. Now fingering wise, what I'm doing is I'm going to hammer onto that 12th fret. I'm barring with the 3rd finger to play the 12th fret of the D string there. But you could use the 2nd finger and 3rd finger if that's easier. Just like that. In the second bar we did the same, and then, but now we do a pull off from 12 to 10 in the D string, and we end that with 12th fret in the A string. So that second bar sounds like this. Now the bar after that, the third bar, is similar to our first bar, except we start off with those two power chords. So the third bar sounds like this. This is before. And then in this fourth bar, what we've got is a to begin with, then we have a little kind of bending lick. So it's actually two guitar parts here. So the first guitar part, what it's doing is it's playing a bend. So it's a kind of whole step bend. 12th fret of the G string. Bend up. Then you would pull off 12 to 10 in the G string and finish it with 12 on that D string. So you have this. I slow it down. Now the second guitar part is kind of playing a harmony. What it's doing is doing. So it's doing a bend at the 12th fret. Full step bend. And then it's doing a pull off from 12 to 10 in the B string, and then 11th fret in the G string. So it just depends which part you want to play, or if you've got two guitarists playing it, you know, one can play, one can play. When I was playing it, I just opted to play the lower harmony part. So the next two bars are actually the riff that's kind of played over the verse. So what we're doing is we're playing a D power chord up at the 12th fret here. So we're kind of barring these bottom E, A, D strings at the 12th fret. Now rhythmically what we're doing is we're kind of playing on beat 1 and beat 3 of the bar, and then in beats 2 and 4 we've got silence, complete rest. So what we do is we kind of do, so we have to silence that guitar, make sure that nothing rings out. And then in beat 3 we do the same. Now the next bar we do the same. And in beat 3 we've got, but in beat 4 we have is this kind of quick change to play the C power chord here. So what we do is we kind of got, and play that C power chord. Now what I'm doing here is I'm kind of I've got that kind of rest or percussive sound to give it a kind of, it's almost as if you're setting up that C power chord. And if you do, if you think of the strict alternate picking, it can help if you do that with an upstroke just to kind of lock into the rhythm of it. So those first six intro bars sound like this.